Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
And welcome to Chinwag number 60, which is excellent. Thank you for joining us this evening. We're not so organised this evening.
We're really not.
Yeah.
It's not a surprise, really. There's very few weeks we're like really, really organised. So.
But this is extra unorganised. I think we went out, picked the girls up, took them out for something to eat.
We did.
And then we came home. And I
went to sleep.
Yeah, and then I went to sleep.
Yeah. And we quite literally woke up probably about half an hour ago.
Well, I actually heard news on the radio about a disturbance at Oxford Street, which at one point looked like it could have been something really, really serious. Apparently, that people heard some kind of shots or gunfire, and I think they shut everything down. So I was listening to that on LBC. It sat down in the living room, and I think it turned out in the end that so far they've not found any evidence of anything. So it could have just been some kind of a disturbance, and it was, you know, it was just, you know, I think that's all it was.
Yeah.
Hopefully, and then I was listening to the radio, and then I dozed up on the sofa as well.
Oh, I think Karin's having trouble with sound.
No sound, says Karin. Okay, if you guys could let us know that everything's
Indie Chick says I can hear fine.
Yeah, if you could let us know, because our stream status is just on okay. Normally it says
normally
good.
It's better than that, it's been struggling, I think.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether it's an internet issue or whether it's something else. I think we're going to have to... Yeah, then you said no gunfire, says Pete's Retro Collectibles. Yeah, so that was quite, obviously having worked on Oxford Street a lot as well and, you know, been there a lot.
And particularly because it's Black Friday as well, so people would have been
A lot of people would have been there shopping. So I was listening to that, and then I think that kind of news went, and then they started with the regular news, and I just fell asleep. Because you'd gone to sleep anyway upstairs.
Okay, we're getting sound is fine.
Sound is fine, fantastic.
Okay, that's great.
Then we ended up just waking up. I think Beck came down at around 6:45.
Yeah, and I said, we should really be sorting out the stream.
Yeah.
Mega
Pixel says, kids having fun playing with fun snaps in central London. It's really sad that that's the kind of times that we live in now where, you know, understandably, I mean, it's kind of good to see how quick the emergency services were able to get there, and you know, in a way it's good to see how we're prepared, but obviously it's not, you know, it's kind of sad that happens. I have sound on my iPad not working on the app on my TV, says Karin. I don't understand why that would be. That's a bit weird. But yeah, it seems to be working at this end, so and the health has gone to good now. Wow, that's weird.
It
started off weird. But yeah, guys, Black Friday. We'll say a few hellos
as well.
Should we start a few hellos?
We haven't done that yet.
So, like I said, welcome to episode 60 of Chinwag. Thank you for joining us, everybody. Bomb Crack Picker, Daisy May, Southwest Sellers, Indie Chick, Karin, Graham Nichols, Ryan, Doing Yourself Lifestyle, Jules joined us, Peter Ray, Will You Take Less, Celtic Traders, Southwest Sellers, Callum Tucker, and many more people. Dr. Doodle Doos, Peter Cummins has joined us as well. Just trying to scroll through and see a few different names. Al's Attic. So Dave Rowland has joined as well. John Breddy, Tactical Bite, Hitman UK, lots of people. Thank you very much for joining us. Old Man Reseller, Reseller Mum, Barry Francis, Andy B, lots of people. I'm going to have to get to the point where I think we're going to have to stop saying out everyone's name because it's really difficult. But yeah, we've got 76 people watching us at the moment, which is fantastic. This for all of you that maybe haven't watched us, but probably everyone in the chat has watched us before. But for those of you that haven't, if anyone stumbles across, this is our Friday night chat, eBay reselling chat predominantly.
We try to.
Well, that's Yeah, that's not what we
every
say.
Week is that serious, but yeah, we do try and talk a bit about reselling.
Yeah, we try to, but it's more of it's just a little recap of our week, really.
Pretty much.
Yeah, and how it's been. Well, if we can get into that, really, can't we? Mm-hmm. This was the first week, obviously, that you started to work back on the main store. Yeah. How's that been for you?
It's been okay.
Yeah.
I've been trying to wind down the second store and do a few sales and
and the funny thing is
promotions.
Yeah. Funny thing is, you've been winding down. You've had some really nice sales come through.
I have. I actually sold a ring this week for £120.
Yeah, we can show that in the second moment, store. Actually. So yeah, you've had a couple other sales come through as well. Okay. Yeah, just make sure he's not getting in trouble.
And yeah, so yeah, a few nice sales from it. Obviously, because I'm not listing on the second store, sales are slowing down, but I am just trying to do basically a clearance rather than relisting everything onto the main store and closing the store that way. I'm just trying to run it down as much as possible, so I'll be doing promoted listings and plenty of sales just to try and shift some of the stock.
That was the sale that Beck got. That's, I'll make us a bit bigger, actually.
I think we made it small last time because you could. Yeah. There was some text that you can see last time. So it says I sold. It says 130. I had it listed for 130, and I actually let it go for 120. I think it was.
So only £10 under your actual asking. So, just to show a few photos of it. So just like a nice little gold ring.
Yeah.
And this, that was a bit blurry, wasn't it?
Yeah, that one was blurry.
But a nice photo of the gold. Yeah. The hallmarks.
I do try and always get a picture of the hallmarks whenever it's hallmarks.
That photo, you take that through your jeweler's look, don't you?
I do. Yeah.
Yeah.
And so using my
that's
phone.
Actually quite a good tip, actually, guys. We might make a video about that, actually, because that's quite a good idea. So when you're doing your jewelry, as you can see, Beck takes the time to take a photo of the hallmark through the jeweler's loop, which can, it's a bit fiddly, isn't it, because you have to hold it up. So hopefully if there is a better way, we'll find that out. But for now, that's works really well, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes you can get a really, really nice clear picture that wasn't necessarily.
I think
so
that's
clear,
a really good one because
you can't see all of them, like the one on the end, you can't see.
Yeah.
But you can see the majority of the hallmarks, which is why I try and do that.
And then show the weight of the.
Yeah, and I'll show the weight of the.
Yeah.
Ring as well. I have had this up for a while.
Yeah, and didn't you get a low ball offer on it as well?
Yeah, of about £25. Yeah. And I was like, no, I just declined it straight away. But yeah, I was really happy with that when that came through this week. I was like, I knew kind of.
It's funny that came through in the week that we're winding down.
I know.
Trevor Hicklin says, Bex, are you closing your store?
Yes, we are closing the second store.
And Chris Newton asked, why are you closing the second store?
Mainly to concentrate on one eBay
when we
store.
Say closing,
it will still be active. So if I want to go and start selling on it again, I will continue. I mean, I've dropped right down to the basic store.
Yeah. And at the moment, we're working on just, I think we're going to keep it running because if there's still a decent amount of decent stock on there.
Yeah.
And, there's some nice items on there.
There are some really nice items.
But we're just going to let it run down and hope, run some sales and promotions. Yeah. That's the plan.
Yeah. I mean, the store's going to be active for a long time yet. I mean, I've still got 600... Is it 650 odd listings on there at the minute? So,
But we're just going to kind of let it. As you saw, there are some really nice items on there. That's not like a rubbishy item.
I've decided to close it. I felt like we were pulling in two different directions, and I wanted to. When I wanted to work with Zahir, it wasn't to be. Separate.
It's going to sound corny, but we actually wanted to work together,
and I felt like our focuses were on completely different things because your store is already established, and
And you weren't feeling.
And I wasn't feeling a part of the main store. Yeah. And then I was sitting there and thinking, well, do we really want to, big stores?
Sure. Because we've noticed that obviously to do eBay, let's be honest, there's lots of ways to earn money online from home, mm-hmm. right? eBay is the one that most of us love. That's why we're here. To be honest with yourself, it takes a lot of mm-hmm. time and it takes up a lot of space as well, to do it, and get a decent monthly income from it.
Yeah.
We're already taking up, you know, we've said this before, this is mm-hmm. the nicest room in the house by a country mile.
We don't use it.
It's heartbreaking almost that we have to actually use mm-hmm. it as a stock room. And I know that's like a small mm-hmm. issue, but then to also then give up further space for a second store,
mm-hmm.
I feel that, you know, and not just space, it's mm-hmm. the time, isn't it? Like yeah. the time it takes to maintain and
so
run.
So we just assessed things and yeah. decided that was the direction that we wanted yeah. to take with it.
Exactly. So, run on yeah. one store, you know, it obviously then the other thing is mm-hmm. On a smaller note, but the fees obviously did also play a small part, but I would say it was more of a small part because I think the main thing for us was, you know, wanting to feel like we're on the same team. Like I want Beck to be excited when we get a cool sale on the main store, when mm-hmm. we're having these really great weeks. And, you know, I think hopefully going forward it will. It will happen like that. Karin says, yes, yesterday was epic for sales. Really pleased. Yes, sales have been pretty good, haven't they? Saying that, Black Friday has been a complete washout so far. we've had... you've had a couple of offers on the second store, which I thought...
I'm not getting into this. No, we've already had an argument about this.
We don't have to get into it. Beck had a couple of offers today that I would have personally just taken. But, you know, it's, like you said, it's down to you. And I'm, you know me, I'm cool with that, you know.
Yeah, yeah. That's good.
I didn't make a big deal out of it, do I?
No.
No.
And, just moaned at me for half an hour.
I didn't
in the
moan. I was just voicing my opinion.
Yeah.
That was all it was. It was
no, I understand that. Yeah. And I do respect your opinion.
And
but...
then you told me to shove it. You respected my opinion.
In not so many words, but yes. Yes.
And apart from that, I think on the main store today, we have had nothing. I've literally just accepted a couple of offers on some toys. I've got stacks of these bad boy toys. This is one of my favorite toys. That's why I keep it by the desk. This is an eye.
No, tell the truth. You actually put it on your shirt and run around
I don't run around the house, but I like to annoy the kids with this by telling them that, like, I've just had an operation and, you know, like, you know, and they roll their eyes because, you know, like, their dad's an idiot. So it works well, though, doesn't it?
It does.
This thing is so cool, though, because, like, you press the button and it goes... Ryan knows all about these, but these are so cool. I love these. But, yeah, someone's actually just bought... I've got two styles... This is becoming like an infomercial.
I've got
like two styles of these, and there's like a triangle one, there's a circle one. Someone's just made offers on both, mm-hmm. And which I've accepted because hopefully gonna just buy two, so that'll be a nice little sale for me.
Which one do you prefer?
Which one do I prefer?
I think you must prefer the circle.
The circle one's the one I've opened. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, I like both. Barrios, is he a slave driver?
Not really. You're not?
No.
Actually, no.
I just let you get on with it.
You do. You let me plan my day. It's normally up to me. But you have given me a box of...
RC parts
to go through, which is fun.
Yeah, I did say to Beck, here you go, this is your first...
This is your first
job to go through. So, and it was a bunch of RC parts that I just haven't...
I'm doing okay with it. There's a lot of sorting and there's a lot of, you know, items to go through. But yeah, it's good fun.
Yeah, it's really... I think it's obviously different from what you're used to listing on them on the second store.
Yeah. But I was getting a bit stressed with it, though, wasn't I? They're like Model Zone branded, aren't they? Are they Model Zone branded? The RC parts?
Yes,
the car
are.
Zone ones that I've been doing.
Yeah.
What is he doing?
He's
got his toy.
Yeah.
So this week I could not find these for the life of me. And you... actually
I said
actually
to
said
her
to me, oh,
I said to her okay, here's
this.
A box of these parts I haven't gotten around to them They say model zone, but you're gonna have to search under HSP, which is the like Chinese kind of budget RC manufacturer, but their parts are popular and they work with a number of brands, so they're all different parts.
And I said to
Rebecca, if you need any help, let me know. So Rebecca obviously goes and sorts all these parts out in bags. Everything's going swimming, and then you just
I get upstairs to start my template and my drafts,
yeah,
and that goes all fine, and then I sit there and I'm like, I can't remember what he asked
but
me to
but she didn't want
under.
To ask me
but I didn't want to you ask you no. again, so I'm just trying to find it myself,
and it was an exercise in frustration, wasn't it?
I ended up coming down and shouting and going, I can't find it.
But since then you've been fine on it, haven't you? So actually got 15 listings done yesterday, which has been nice because it's allowed me to dig out a few more like difficult sales to ship and deal with, like that need testing, etc. And it's something we need to do. Megapixel says phishing for partial refunds. I'm intrigued. Doesn't sound legit or in keeping with eBay's regulations, so I assume we will ignore such requests. Yes, guys, the title for this video is the title for this video is about phishing for partial refunds, because there have been a couple of occasions recently where this has happened to us, and we will talk to you guys
we'll touch
about
on
it
that in a bit. Did you want to get on and show the rest of yourselves?
I just want to mention hold on, did Z ask Bex to work on the main source so he could have a sleep? Outrageous. And Sib says, FYI, Z, I miss the side chat bar even if no one else does. Thanks, Sib. I really appreciate it.
You miss it too, don't you?
Yeah, I like the side chat bar. I'd have all kinds of graphics on the screen, but I need to kind of get a nice balance so it doesn't look too full up, because I do agree with people saying that this isn't a gaming stream, it's a reselling chat, so you don't need to have like too much going on, do we? No, we don't know. Right, a few people saying great sales. I'm guessing about the ring we showed. Nice Del Boy ring. Yes, it was a bit of a Del Boy.
It was actually.
Listed a Star Wars keys and sold in less than 24 hours as Karin. Okay, Megapixel, I just want to say, now that I'm looking to go full-time, watching Zero and Nick's videos and learning from all you guys in chat and the Facebook group is a real comfort and makes me feel less alone on this path. It's how you felt, isn't it?
Yeah, you can feel so lonely.
Especially, really, I mean, it will become easier over time, but like you're still in that thing where you remember what it's like to have work colleagues and
it's just different because your work colleagues are people online now.
Yeah.
And although you don't necessarily see them face to face, you can still communicate with them, either with the Facebook group or through Insta, because Insta's got a really nice community on there as well.
So it is something it's something you have to adapt to. The community online is so important in so many ways, and it like has been mentioned in the previous chat, it's not all about the information that's shared. Sometimes it's just about the fact that we're communicating. There was quite a few comments on the last video that I on the last Chinwag we did, me and Nick, where there were a few comments about I don't watch videos necessarily for what's the kind of information necessarily, but more for just the social aspect of it. So that does play into it a fair bit. Okay, question, are you paying Bex a commission for listing, i.e. $2.99 per listing? We are a team, Ryan. Don't start stirring. Triangle one is good, lol. Expensive. Why is it £5 more, though? Oh, you're talking about the Iron Man.
Well, why is it £5 more? I was going to ask you that when I saw that offer.
I don't know. Just it is, it's market forces and things, it just the way...
Did you just make up the price?
It's difficult to say.
He just made up the price.
Here is a box of old plastic and metal in some bags that Southwest has. That's pretty much what it is.
That's what it was.
Are you getting familiar with all the RC parts now?
I haven't got a clue.
It just shows. Well, that's good because that shows you don't need to have a clue.
Yeah.
You don't need to have a clue. Z, did you buy a new phone on Black Friday? Asked Andy. No, I am still without a phone.
Yeah.
It's a bit of a.
Kind of missing it, but not missing it as well.
Yeah, I'm enjoying. Do you know what I'm really enjoying about not having a phone is I get really excited now to check my emails. because that's how I now know or to go on the PC.
Yeah, an offer.
Exactly. Yeah. So I'm really excited about that part of it. But on the other hand, it's very difficult to reply to, for example, reply to messages and not being able to send a photo with the message. It's suddenly a longer process for me to do that. I'm actually having to borrow Rebecca's phone to take photos to list. So it's certainly not ideal, and it's certainly not going to stay like that. I just have to kind of,
exactly. You know,
get back and get a phone. Right. Let's see. Hitman says, I know many of you have YouTube vids. If you do, can you say now so I can subscribe? Oh, that's cool. Yeah, definitely. Razer mobile phone, get saving, says Ryan. I would love to have the Razer phone,
but
£600. Actually, that's quite a nice way to get
into the next
another topic that we wanted to talk about. I would love to buy the Razer phone at £600. I absolutely think it's gorgeous, and I love Razer stuff. Razer, if you don't know, let's just call him Alfie. Let's call him. Sorry, that's the dog trying to open the door where his food is kept. So he's being a bit naughty. yeah, for those of you that don't know, Razer is like a brand. They do like gamer stuff, so watches, keyboards, mice, that kind of thing. And I obviously would love to have their phone, but it's £600. It's quite a premium device. And normally I might have ended up buying it, mightn't I?
Yeah.
But as you guys know, we've got a lot of ambitions. The main one being at some point we would love to own our own home rather than rent. So we have a lot of money that we need to save to do that.
We do.
To get financially stable, to just get completely debt free would be another thing that obviously we need to do before we can go and buy a house. And it's just silly that we are in that position. You know, it's just daftness, just you know, not great decisions. And the thing is, I was getting more and more aware of this, especially like when I've got so many gadgets. As some of you guys know, if I find something cool, there's a chance I might keep it.
Yeah.
You know, you don't do this, do you?
Not very often.
No, it's more me, isn't it?
I do it sometimes.
Yeah, but... I mean, for guys that don't know, let me just show you. This is the Razer phone. I'm going to have to make myself smaller again.
Yeah, see,
just,
that's just why you made show you. It smaller last time.
Oh, guys, look at this. This is the Razer phone. I absolutely love it. This thing is gorgeous. It's everything I'd want. And I know it sounds so silly, but that little logo on the back, it is amazing. And Krillin has super chatted $2. Thank you, Krillin.
Did you
name the dog after the TV show? I loved Alf, the TV show, but no, Alfie was already named.
He was already named, and we decided not to change his name.
Yeah. He almost certainly does need a Razer, says Dave Rowland. I'm guessing that's a pun on the recent growth in facial hair.
Yeah. Can I just say, regarding that, he's actually threatened today that he's growing the beard and he's growing the hair at the same time.
What do you mean threatened? You didn't. You see it as what do you mean threatened? Like,
yeah, you did.
What?
Because I'm not sure that you'll keep up with it because you've said it before.
Yeah, no, but this is longer than it's ever been. This is way longer.
Have you measured it?
No, I've not measured it, but like this is no, because you know what? I'm getting really like long bits.
I know you keep playing with it. It's really annoying.
And I did quite an important test today, which was. Like, I went to McDonald's and I had, like, something from their premium collection, their classic burger with the sauce.
Oh, did you do the bid?
Yeah, and I cannot, I'm honestly someone that cannot that what messes up beards for me is when I'm eating burgers, because any other food it's okay because you can cut it with a knife and fork and just put it in your mouth straight. With a burger, right, I'm not going to be sitting
I
there.
I can't believe you're talking about it.
I'm just explaining my situation.
Okay, you're right.
Yeah, my main reason for not growing a beard is because if I like to eat burgers, mm-hmm. and eating a burger with a beard has just been really frustrating, especially when you get bite and you get the sauce and then you're like wiping it. It's just horrible. And like, I thought it was going to happen today, and I thought I'd be coming home going, Beck, I've had enough, I need to get this off. It's just irritating me.
It's normally like yeah. cheese and stuff like
the
that.
The cheese gets stuck or the, mm. you know, it's just not pleasant. Yeah. But today I wharfed that mofo down, didn't I? Yeah. So... And
okay. should we carry on? We still haven't gotten to the part where we actually showed the rest of yourselves, and we're
right.
like half an hour in.
Okay, guys, so, sorry for the. See, this is why we said this is like, you know, right. Let's have a look at this. So yeah, this is the phone I wanted. This is called the Razer phone. That's all it is. But yeah, that's the phone I wanted. Mm-hmm. And normally, I think I would have ended up buying it. So. You know, gorgeous and everything you want. How much dollars to shave? Says like Krillin. I don't know, man. I'm not going into it.
You're not going there, no.
Yeah. So anyway, like I said, this is quite important because for me, anyway, I end up buying stuff, mm-hmm. and we've got aims. Like I said, we want to at some point buy a house. Oh wow, Darren has just super chatted £10 towards the Razer phone fund.
That's very nice of you, thank
that,
you.
That is very kind of you, Darren. Appreciate it. But yeah, I'm not starting a fund for the Razer phone. I'm trying to break my like bad habits, mm-hmm. because you know, we've got aims, we want to own a house, we want to get ourselves financially stable, and it's silly that the notifications yep. have just come up. Thank you so much. But we need to start acting like the position that we're in, you know, mm-hmm. and I think especially when the eBay started to build up and we're making sales, and you know, it's too easy to be like, oh, I got item X for really cheap, I can keep it.
Yeah.
And that's mm-hmm. why I want to talk about the next thing. This is might surprise some of you guys, but I made a sale this week that for me is such a big deal. I'm actually going to make a video about it as well. It's going to be my memorable sale number 2, so in my series of videos about memorable sales, this sale is definitely one that I'm, you know, proud of doing. Mm-hmm. But I'm also heartbroken. This was a tough one.
Yeah.
And I know some of you say that's silly, just get on, do it. And you're right, that's what I should be doing.
Yeah.
And that's what I've done, but it's taken me a while to get here.
It's really nice to have Nick and Andrea to talk to, because they've also been telling you, just sell it.
Yeah. let me just switch, guys. I sold my coffee machine.
Was that a sad head down?
it's sad for me.
Aww,
it's sad.
For you.
Okay, we bought this coffee machine from eBay a few months ago, and I bought it from eBay for £87. Yeah. I bought it for £87. Okay, and you know, I love my coffee, as you guys know. This is a commercial machine. Mm-hmm. I had a commercial coffee grinder with it. And I had to have it set up. Indie Chick, Dave Ramsey's fantastic. I've been listening to a lot of Dave Ramsey.
Yeah,
and
I think
that's
what... I need to start listening to him, because I've been catching you listening to him, and I've been like, wow, this guy.
I'm really sad, but it's because of listening to people like Dave Ramsey that I've taken the step to do this. Because we got this for £87. That is a steal, okay? That is an absolute steal, £87. I sold it for $300. Mm-hmm. Okay, I bought this off of eBay for $87, and I sold it for $300. I took mm-hmm. an offer. I didn't get $400. I got $300, so still not bad. Plus £15 shipping. Now this machine is amazing. It had hot water on demand. It was a heat exchanger machine. Mm-hmm. Really strong steam, didn't it? Really good machine.
It was.
You know.
But it was a proper
overkill.
Professional machine, and it was. We actually bought it.
I'm going to come out and say it. I don't deserve it. Yeah, it was used in a pub. I'm going to come out and say it. I don't deserve it. We have got bills to pay,
mm-hmm.
right? We want to buy a house. You know, there will be a time for me to have a coffee machine.
Mm-hmm.
And not only will I have a coffee machine, I'll get an even better... when I can mm-hmm. afford it, I'll get a really good one. When I can afford it, I will get a really good one. I'll get like a double group one. I'll get one that gets plumbed in, you know. But I'll do it in my kitchen, you know, not in my rented kitchen. Mm. I mean, this didn't even fit in the kitchen because it was too big. You didn't like that, did you?
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
No.
So, you know, and Dave Rowland has just super chatted £2. Start a fund to buy a new coffee machine. Old man reseller super chatted £5. One thing I know, if you want it, buy it. But that's gotten me into a bit of trouble.
Yeah.
If you want it, buy it. And I just feel that there will be a time and a place.
There will be.
But I can't sit here, you know, in renting mm-hmm. And to have bills. I mean, we want to be debt free completely before we can do that as well. You know, we want to be debt free before we can buy a house. You need to be debt free completely, you know. And I can't sit there with, you know, £300 of coffee machine, and do that. So
no.
I, you know, I'm really upset. My grinder is going to be going up for sale as well, which is like, I've not listed that yet, but not because I'm like having second thoughts. I've just got to complete the listing. I've taken the photos and everything. So my coffee grinder is going to go for sale mm-hmm. up for sale as well. So I'm proud of myself. I think mm-hmm. Beck, are you proud of me?
I'm pretty proud of you.
Yeah. Really?
Mainly this and the other item you've got to show as well. So yeah, I am proud of you this week.
Yeah. So, thank you. See, she's proud of me, guys. I'm happy about that. But yeah, so I'm happy that I've done that. And going forward, we need to do things the right mm-hmm. way, you know. There'll be a time, there'll be a place. Sibas, you have a grinder account. A coffee grinder, Sib, as I'm sure you know, but
yes.
I know what you're like. So.
And yeah. Dave Ireland is asking, am I happy that the coffee machine is gone? Yes, I am, because it was too big to stay in the kitchen.
And we had it in the office,
Yeah, and it was making a bit of a mess out here.
Yeah.
So I am, yes.
Yeah.
Overall, I'm pretty happy that it's gone.
what's the other question? A few comments coming in, actually. Adam Kelsey says £300 half a razor phone. That wouldn't really be me learning my lesson now, would it? And that's the other thing. I don't want to... I think I'm going to buy like a cheap secondhand set. I'm due an upgrade on my phone contract, so I could actually just go to Tesco now and upgrade to a new phone. And again, that's something I would have done, right?
Yeah.
True? As mm-hmm. soon as my upgrade used to come, I used to be upgrade, didn't I? I always mm-hmm. used to upgrade my phone, always, without... And like, the last couple of years, it was super easy, because I was like, oh, mm-hmm. I'm a reseller, I need it. You know, I need to have the best camera available. So mm-hmm. click, and there you go. Suddenly, my monthly contract is like £40 a month or something. And, you know, I'm just... I'm glad I'm not doing that as well. I'm going to look for a cheap secondhand phone that I can just run, and I'm hopefully going to be happy.
Yeah.
Right, Lolzy, you know what I'm like. Yes, Sib, we do. Save for a deposit, guys, and scale that store up big. I want 100k plus eBay store from you next year. Think big. That's exactly what we're looking to do. Think big.
I mean, we are gonna push the eBay store
to its max.
We are gonna be looking at other things on the side as well. So.
Exactly. Bex for director of Malik Limited. Push that employees are here, Bex. Adam says, what puns will we have left? Bex, are you happy for him to stop grinding? I'll see that.
Yes.
Fresh coffee, you mean, clearly.
Yes.
Clearly, obviously. I mean, what else could you mean?
What else could it be?
Right. I'm with Tesco Mobile, Graham Nichols. Yeah, Tesco Mobile is my phone contract provider. Yeah. So if I wanted to, I could go and upgrade my phone now, because I'm due an upgrade.
Yeah, they did a really good SIM-only package, didn't they?
Exactly.
So I was pretty happy with them.
Yeah. So That's the thing. By the way, I did see Nick in the chat as well, and Andrea. So hi, guys. Just wanted to say hi. I'm not ignoring you. Rob Crossland as well. Celtic Traders, did I say? Caroline, I think I did.
I think so. Yeah. I think we did.
Okay. Right. Now, the second sale is a bit of, again, carrying on this whole thing about getting rid of things that I shouldn't have. Mm-hmm. And also, it's going to then lead us into our topic of the chat.
Yes.
So if you've managed to stick it out for 40 minutes listening to this,
well done.
Thank you. Yeah. All right. Let me just get that screen up so I can just share this.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, guys. This is another sale we had this week, which I'm proud of. And it's my Losi petrol truck. As some of you guys know, mm-hmm. I bought this over the summer. And I got it for a steal of a price. I got it for like £350 with a mm-hmm. handset and transmitter. The handset and transmitter alone sold for around 200 and something. Yeah. And then I've just sold this for 350. So a good couple hundred pound profit instantly. This truck, brand new, is about £600. And I really, really wanted to keep it, didn't I? I really wanted to keep it. But then again, listening to people like Dave Ramsey, I realised at the moment I should be too tired to even want to play toy cars.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I shouldn't have the time to be playing toy cars, should I? It just shouldn't happen, right? And I just thought there will be a time and place. And when I get one again, I will get the best one I can. Mm-hmm. Because the other side of it is, I had fooled myself at first thinking, oh, this only owes me like 150 quid. It's mm-hmm. a bargain. Brand new, these are 600. But the facts are, I couldn't justify repair costs.
No.
If I broke anything on this thing, it would cost quite a bit of money, and I certainly couldn't justify spending like £30-40 on like some parts mm-hmm. or whatever. So in the end, it made sense. Ryan is having a fit in the chat.
Southwest Sellers just asked, is this the one that Nick crashed? No, Nick actually crashed the little electric
one. Which is also going to be going, because
going well.
Again, it was an impulse purchase.
Yeah, that one's not listed yet though.
No, that's not listed, yeah. Has Pex lost the job, asked Dave Rowland? No. Reseller Mum says, such a great change of mindset. Dave Ramsey is not someone who I'd agree with in a lot of ways, because he's quite a Republican, which isn't a bad thing, but he can be quite like right, kind of right, to the right, mm-hmm. I suppose, but not getting political. But some of his stuff is like, you know, very much, oh, there's no excuse, just mm-hmm. do it. And I'm kind of trying to adopt that. There's no excuse, just do it. Dave Ramsey, he helped get millions of people in America out of debt and out of the debt mindset. And, you know, and I just feel that he's... is he on YouTube, asked Nick? Yeah, he's on YouTube. He's got a radio show. He's been on Oprah and whatever. He was a real estate guy mm-hmm. who made millions and then lost it all, and then mm-hmm. he realized he didn't want to be in debt. And so he's very funny. I love listening to him because he's hilarious.
He is.
Yeah, he's from Tennessee, Nashville. And he's got this amazing character where mm-hmm. people ring him up and say stuff like, "Hi, Dave, we've got this car," and he'll just rip them. You know, he's kind of, obviously some of it's done for entertainment purposes, I guess. But the point is quite good. I ignore those bits, lol, says Reseller Mum. But he's really funny, and something about him has resonated.
I think that's the thing. I think if someone kind of that you're able to,
because you've been telling me this stuff for years.
Yeah. But if there's someone that you can listen to and you relate to, or you know, you just like the way they put something.
Yeah.
And I think that's something that I've noticed with him, because you do.
I definitely relate to him.
To
this bit. Yeah. I think I probably relate to him more than you do in a way, but
I don't think I've listened to
enough.
Loads.
Yeah.
But
you don't have the issue in a way. Like, you know, Beck has always been of the mindset, I'll wait until the time is right. Whereas me, I'm just like, just buy, you know. Yeah. And it's really bad.
And we've always had this.
It's just, No, this isn't even about saving for Christmas. We've actually gotten a lot of the girls... we've all gotten a lot of the girls' presents and things. It's more of my...
Change.
It's like a personal... Yeah. It's a personal... For me, it's... it's we could afford to keep this stuff. You know, the coffee machine cost me 87 quid. This car doesn't owe me much. I could afford to keep it in some warped sense. But in reality, I can't. You know, when I don't have my own house, I shouldn't have any of this. Like, the way I'm thinking now is, until I own my own house, I shouldn't have any of this stuff. I just shouldn't. And I'm like, it's more of a personal change for me. I want to be really focused, you know. I want to be just focused on doing that. This stuff, there's time for it, you know. And plus, I wasn't even, I didn't use the damn things.
You took it out.
Yeah.
Once or twice, maybe.
Yeah. I totally agree why you sold the RC car, says Megapixel. I have a Nitro Raptor size 30 heli that I can't afford to crash. Therefore, I shouldn't really have it. Looks handsome on display, though. Smiley faces, Megapixel. Mm-hmm. Yeah, see, that's just the thing. Your Raptor 30 size helis are huge. I had one, actually. And yeah, they're amazing items. But yeah, if you crash that thing, you're talking hundreds in repairs. Yeah. I mean, same with this. If I broke one suspension arm, I'm looking at like 20 quid for a piece of plastic.
On the flip side, falling on a bruise, which I think is Andrea, but you could drop dead tomorrow, have a hobby.
Yeah.
I still spend time on having goats and chickens. No point waiting till I'm old. Go down to the allotment.
I think I agree with you, and I think in that way I'm getting so much joy out of having Alfie. You know, Alfie's obviously, you know, he's now like a member of our family, but he obviously brings with him his own costs. But I'm enjoying going out, walking with Rebecca and walking with Alfie. And, you know, there's lots of things I can enjoy. I can enjoy time with my kids. I can, you know, there's so many other things I can enjoy. You know, I just feel that at the moment, these just feel frivolous to me. And I'm like, it's just it was a mindset thing. These were almost symbolic sales for me because they're things that I love so much. You know, like, I love this RC stuff. I love coffee. You guys know I'm mad for it. But you know what? When I want to treat myself, if I'm feeling like it, I'm just going to go to a coffee shop. I'll go to a good coffee shop instead. And I'll be able to sit down and I'll have a barista make me a nice flat white or whatever drink I want. Or my guilty pleasure at this time of year is to go to Starbucks and have an eggnog latte. Now, that's not cheap, you know, spending £3-4 ago, but I'll still treat myself in those ways. It's just having those things in the house, I like, you shouldn't really have that, dude. It's a commercial coffee machine, for God's sake. I kept on saying to myself, you know.
Not to mention the professional grinder as well.
Commercial grinder,
which was commercial too grinder, tall to again fit in the kitchen.
Yeah, so. Exactly. Now, the other reason I wanted to talk about this car, this sale here,
it leads us onto our topic,
this leads us on to our next topic, guys. It's now 7:47, so thank you for sticking with us. I know we've rambled a lot, but we've got the title of our topic is like phishing, increase in phishing for partial refunds. What do we mean by that? What would you like to say about it, honey? The increase in phishing?
I don't think there's necessarily been a great increase in it, but we have had a few.
We've had a couple, and it's just been a bit weird. There's been a couple of items, hasn't there? Both RC items, both of which we've sold, and then you it's not that they've just come out and, you know, they've just, they're basically, there seems to be a formula. Someone buys an item from you, they will then message you with a fault. They will say to you, I received the item today, because we always send our stuff tracked, so that's all great. And we always package it really well. I'm confident that whatever I ship out is going to arrive. If it arrives, it's going to arrive in one piece. I'm always confident in that. And so item arrives, you will get a message, and the message will be along the lines of, it doesn't work properly, it doesn't this or it doesn't that. To which you obviously reply, oh, I'm, you know, sorry that's happened. Maybe it got bumped in transit, or maybe it's just bad luck. Either way, I offer a 30-day no quibble return. And that's when it gets funny, isn't it? No? And that's when it gets like funny. What happens next? You tell them.
Well, then from there.
Yeah.
Then, I don't know. They, you dealt with this week. You put me on the spot, man. I thought you were going to talk about it.
No, I want you to talk about it.
Anyway, right, so then, right, so you did the whole, you know, message and said, you know, offer a 30-day refund. And then they come back and they say, oh, it may be this, I'm going to try this.
And you don't ask them to try anything.
And you're not asking them to try anything. You're asking them, you know, if you want to cancel, we're returning.
Well, we had a peculiar one where we sold someone a part, like an RC part.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually a little man that sits on the bike. And he said it doesn't fit. Yeah. And it had to fit because there's no other, that's the official part, yeah, that was it.
It's like a model thing.
And apparently the guy didn't have the time to make it to the post office to return it. It wasn't worth, he couldn't find the time. He was always at work, apparently. Mm-hmm. But yet then he had the time to say to me, I'll tell you what, I'll adjust it and cut it and make it fit. How about you just give me a partial refund? He just came out and asked. And we were like, no, just send it back. He threatened us with negative feedback, etc. In the end, we just ignored him and he went away. And again, the same thing has happened with this RC car. We've sent the car out. It's arrived and then we've had a message saying, oh, it's not running. And I'm like, oh, that's funny, because it was running when before I sent it off. I always make sure, blah blah
yeah,
blah.
Yeah, I mean, you did, yeah, you did actually test
it. I did test it as well.
You know,
well, yeah,
it's something you've been using anyway.
Exactly.
So you knew that
I knew
it was
fully
running
all the components
that there weren't
fine.
Necessarily the issue that he was saying. So that's why we kind of said, look,
that's,
you know,
I said, I mean, if it's not working, you know, send it back.
Yeah.
And then, I was told he didn't want to send it back. He'll try a few other, he's got a few carburetors from other cars that he'll use or whatever. And apparently it started working when with these other parts that he used. How about, would I be willing to buy a car for X amount of money? So basically a partial refund. I obviously said, no, I don't want that.
Yeah.
Just send it back.
You did actually just state, no, I'm not asking you to do that.
No.
I've told
if
you
it's not working,
to return the
send
item
it,
to me if you're not happy.
Yeah. I said, no, I don't want to buy.
Partial refund isn't something that
I'm not
going
to buy a part that you've just put on.
Yeah.
And then you get the, oh, that's fine, I'll send it back.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're like, brilliant. And that's it. Open the case. That's it. And then magically, again, they decide against it. Now,
we have been getting a few of these.
Well,
but
these two stick out because they're both with the RC stuff, and it's actually been the cars that have been more of an issue.
Yeah,
and there was another RC car that there was an issue, wasn't there? The truck, the Kyosho truck, which again, the guy actually tried to leave me a negative feedback and it got removed. It's actually been the cars more. Parts I'm selling and getting comeback from.
We've had a couple returns, but it was more people ordering the wrong part and they hadn't even opened it and they're just like, you know, really sorry, ordered the wrong part.
Yeah,
can
and they
I return
it
to you? And we're like, yeah, that's fine. There's no issue with that at all. It's more the, you know, they clearly want the item, but you know, they were trying to get a bit more of a discount.
Yeah,
maybe they just weren't happy with the price they paid in the end or whatever it was, but it's just
It's definitely like an attitude with I think the cars, especially because of the nature of them, because they're so easy to say, oh, this isn't working or that isn't working. And I just find that people are trying these things. I mean, if they really wanted to be kind of dodgy, what they could do, but they can't be bothered, is to just swap the part out that they want, because these cars are designed to be repaired, and then send it back. But most of them don't want to do that. They want to keep the car. They want, you know, it doesn't make much sense to me, but it's a bit frustrating, and it's just a reminder that if you do get anyone fishing for it, just say, look, don't deal with partial refunds. I first came across that kind of mindset from the scavenger life because they've mentioned it on numerous occasions that they very much stick to, okay, just return it.
Yeah.
And then that's it. Because a lot of times the you can tell what's coming because it will be like a passive aggressive style comment. Yeah. As in they'll just send you a message telling you it's not working. I mean, that's, without actually asking for anything.
That's the thing that's been very similar in most of these cases.
It's like a trait. It's like
they're not even asking for anything when they're telling you a message. They're just sending you a message saying it doesn't work.
Yeah.
And you're like, well, okay, what do you want?
What do you want? Yeah,
and then
what
that's
do you want?
When you go, okay, well, I'm sorry it doesn't work. I offer a 30-day
it back,
return it, and then
that's
the
when that's when the excuses
kind of
come out
and they're like, I haven't got time for sending it. That was one of them, wasn't it? I haven't got time to send it back through the post office. And I understand that people are busy,
but no one's that busy
that because no one
but when you're telling me that you've got the time to sit and modify a part rather than go to a post office, it doesn't make any sense, does it? So I just don't want to, you just don't want to kind of, I feel like partial refunds, it just should be a no-no. Shops don't operate that, you know, you can't, you know, if you buy an item from a retailer, you can't just say, I tell you what, just give me 50 quid off and we'll call it a day. No, it doesn't work like that, you know, it just doesn't. And I think people try to play that, and they'll actually try to play that more, I think, on it depends really on the items, but I think certain items might attract it more than others.
Yeah, maybe. Pete's Retro Collectibles has said, no, you're scrolling up and I can't read it now. It says, if they don't ask, don't reply.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's quite a good point.
Well, if they don't actually ask
for anything. Yeah, if they're not asking for anything. Yeah.
Alia says, I thought Zahir was really nice when he turned over a new leaf asking Beck's opinion, then he put her on the spot.
I got caught out, I think a couple of people noticed. I tuned out for a second.
Well, I'm making an effort to... No, because I'm making an effort because you said to me, you know, and it's true, I do talk a lot.
Yeah.
And, you know, you should be talking more, you know.
Not
just like it has to be 50% or anything, but I'm just saying that, you know, I should let you talk.
I don't have that much to say to talk for 50%.
Okay, but like, I should let you talk, right? Like, take a breath. Yeah. And that's what I did.
Yeah.
And I caught you out.
I think you'd actually been, like, people had actually said, you know.
Yeah, if people had said, you know, took a breath. So I took that on board, and then I find that you just don't listen to what I'm talking about, you know.
No, I was listening.
Put you on the spot.
I was listening, but I was, like, listening to the way you were telling it.
Oh, right, okay. But yeah, I find that this is something that, you know, you've got to stay firm with, guys.
Yeah.
Don't be offering partials.
I mean, you're normally the one that handles these messages because my initial...
You haven't had that, have you? But your initial reaction
tends to
be...
Yeah, it wouldn't be good. It wouldn't be good for me to reply, honestly.
Yeah.
You know, I think is it Caroline, Mrs. M, where she types out what she wants to say and then deletes it?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I probably wouldn't delete it. I'd actually
send it. Yeah.
So, customer service, which is quite a surprise because I had to, you know, be very...
I think that's probably why you've got no tolerance now, because you used it all up.
I just...
Maybe you used up all your tolerance. That was it.
But now my first initial reaction is just like, oh my goodness.
Ryan says, I've told three people this month, don't threaten me with negative feedback, return the item, and they soon go away. And Sib, you're right, in a way it's good if they threaten you with it, because then it will be seen as blackmail, etc., and get removed. But I'm just saying, from the point of view that people are just trying to get a bit of extra cash off of you, Nick says calling their bluff is the way to go. There is a growing culture for phishing for refunds. I think it literally is people buy something and they just wanted it that much cheaper. The other thing that I've noticed is it tends to be on offers, items that you've taken offers on as well.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no hard and fast rules for these things, but I just find that this is happening a little bit. I mean, it's still... I just want to qualify and say it, because two instances have happened within like a 30-day period, which is very rare, and it's probably just two instances that I can remember overall, actually. So it's still a tiny... I just want to put it out there, it's a tiny percentage overall. It's just something that it has come to mind, because obviously we've had it happen.
Yeah.
You know, one after the other, like buses, as it were. Sib has a question. Has anyone found they have had more bullying techniques take place when they had fewer feedback or on a newer eBay account than their big boss account? I do get treated cruddy. I don't think so, Sib, because we've had this hassle from people with smaller accounts than we have. Yeah.
Personally, I haven't noticed it. I mean, my store is very well. I started the second store with only 17 feedback. I've never had experienced that. But it could be the type of items that you deal in.
Funny Bunnies asks, I have a question for you. What's your favorite food? It's a bit random. Burgers. Bex used up all her tolerance being married to Z-Lol, says Barry. Oh, is that true?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Right, guys. We have just about hit... Oh, no, we actually started at 5 past.
We started later. So we'll stay for a little bit longer. Minutes,
yeah,
yeah.
Sib K... Yeah, Pete's Retro Collectible says, Sib, I have 67,000 feedbacks and still happens. There you go. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely that is the case. I think Nick has touched on this before with the whole item not received, that, you know, fight it, or, you know, or they've had a couple of situations where they could have let something go, but they stood up for it. And I think in a way you do have to have that mentality, because I was previously very much of the case that, you know, it's cost of business, blah, blah, blah. And yes, there are situations where that might still apply, where it's not worth your hassle. But when it's something so simple, where it's just a case of saying, okay, return it, it's worth you doing, because I'd rather have those items back and sell them at higher prices. You know, I feel like they've gotten a good deal. I mean, you know, and then on top of that, to then be you know, for them to try to get more money off, is ridiculous. I mean, the guys that have tried these things on me have both gotten good deals. They've not gotten ripped off in any way. Do you know what I mean? And then on top of that, they're trying to get more money off. I'm like, I tell you what, I'd rather take it back and sell it again. That's just how I feel about it. Right. Yeah, Nick says they tend to fabricate a reason so you, the seller, are liable for the return cost, and then use that cost to leverage a partial. Yeah, we have had quite a spate of them recently. Yeah, definitely. I agree, Nick. I think they, like, in this recent case with the Losi, he bought up the return cost, and I was like, no, the return cost will be on me. Don't worry. When you open the case, I will pay for the eBay postage label, so you won't even have to pay for a return postage. You just got to drop it off at your post office. And yeah, we've not heard anything. I don't mind paying the return, because it doesn't cost much in a lot of cases.
They still want to return it, maybe, you know, if they've been busy or whatever and they haven't got around to, you know, opening up a case, we'd still accept the return. It's no issue to us, really, because we're just like, yeah, we'd rather have it back. If you're not happy with it, we'd rather have it back.
Nick says, I need to meet Angry Beck next time we meet up.
Oh, you don't want to meet Angry Beck?
No, Angry Beck is reserved for me, I think.
Yeah.
I get to hear... I don't think you'd ever...
No.
Yeah. Beck will not... It's not a challenge, guys, but she won't... She doesn't lose...
The only people that see Angry Beck is my parents, probably, and you.
Yeah. Angry Beck. Yeah. That's a new thing now. Angry Beck. Beck is you're like cold. Yeah, she's cool. She's a cool customer. Beck is. You're not gonna. Question: what's it like living with veggies here? Truth, says Ryan. Well, Beck has never been a veggie. She's been pescatarian. So you know, not a veggie technically, is it?
No.
Right. Karen says, my philosophies are here. Think they just have very clear business policies in your head, and then find I don't get stressed. That's a really good idea, Karen. Yeah, if you do have solid, if you've got solid rules, it does take it out of you. Like in our head now.
I think that's the difference. I suppose you're better at this than me, and that's why I probably still get a little bit on the angry side when it comes to dealing with issues like this, because I just, you know, maybe it's because I haven't necessarily had to deal with it too much, because I haven't had too many issues on the second store. But yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you've had more experience here, I think, and over time, I suppose. Because was there ever a point for you where you used to get angry and you used to get really frustrated?
Yeah. I remember when I got my first negative feedback or my first neutral feedback.
Yeah.
And I remember calling eBay, trying my best to call them all calmly, and just losing it, like absolutely, like
how
that
could
feedback
you lose was it with eBay?
Because they felt they weren't helping me. Yeah, but I felt they weren't helping me. I was like, you know, I think I got a neutral feedback because some guy found that the intro animation scenes on Doom on the PlayStation 1 were a bit choppy. Because this douche basically bought a video game on the PlayStation 1 and expect... No, I can say it. This complete cretin bought a video game on the PlayStation 1 and expected the cutscenes to be liquid, 60 frames per second, smooth and amazing. Because his feedback was along the lines of, good game, cutscenes are jerky. And I got a neutral for that. Like, as if it's my fault that the cutscenes were jerky in this video game. I lost it. I was like, are you serious? And I was raging. Yeah. I felt they're not supporting me. I was like, you know, this is ridiculous. And I just, you know, yes, you get it becomes easier, definitely. But yeah, that is what happened. Right, guys.
Graham Nichols has got a really nice point. It's like, I think the anger comes from the frustration of such nonsense after all the work you've put in rather than the cost.
Yeah.
That's very true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nick reckons, after walking with me through London for 7 or 8 hours, I could easily annoy Beck enough to unleash.
I'm not sure.
stop trying to outdo Angry Beck, says Adam. And Ryan says, I'd have given a neg if I couldn't complete the game. Yeah, I know, right? I mean, it's just daft. Anyway, guys, can I just say a massive, massive thank you for you guys to watch. Thank you for all the comments. Love the chat. It's been brilliant. We needed it today. I think it was nice, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was nice.
Today's one of those days where I think we looked forward to coming on because cheers us up. It's felt kind of nice sharing with you guys my, like, new, I want to keep like that, you know?
Yeah.
We mentioned minimalism in the last week's chat, didn't we? And it's kind of a bit of that in there as well,
it's,
you know?
It's
not having stuff
that
I don't, yeah.
Isn't it? So,
yeah. You know, yeah. I want to find real happiness, and it's not always in things. So thank you guys for the amazing comments. Thank you everyone who super chatted. We really appreciate the super chats, but honestly, only if you want to. So absolutely amazing. I can't smell anything. Has somebody dropped one? What are you talking about, PCP? Show us Alfie before you go. I don't know where he is, guys.
Let me see if I can.
Alfie, has he gone upstairs? Look for the cat. Oh, okay. We'll give you a quick. Alfie, come up here. Alfie, jump up. Alfie, okay. Come on, Alfie. Okay, he wants to jump up. Alfie, good boy. Come here.
There we go.
Come on. Alfie, come on. There we go, guys. Okay, he wanted to jump up, but he wasn't sure on. Do you want to look at the camera, Alfie? No. Over there, Alfie. What's that?
There we go, guys.
So.
He's a good boy.
Thank you, guys. Oh, what was that?
I think he just burped in your face.
I'm going to move my head away and get to get some dog burp. Yeah. But yeah, he's been epic. Thank you very much for
joining us.
Yeah. You guys have been epic, and we will see you guys in the next video.
We will too.
Borrowing the dog. So lovely. You're lovely. Yeah. Okay, guys. See you later.